Hey guys, hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to take on the parathyroid hormones. The video will be in two parts. In the first part, we'll take on the source of parathyroid hormones, like from where the parathyroid hormones are released or produced. And in the second part, we'll take on the functions of parathyroid hormones, like what are the functions of parathyroid hormones. Okay. So let's take on the source of parathyroid hormones, like from where the parathyroid hormones are released. See guys, all of us know that we have the main gland, that is the thyroid gland. See, this is the thyroid gland and I am taking the posterior view of the thyroid gland. Okay, so I am seeing the thyroid gland from its posterior aspect. On the posterior aspect of the thyroid gland, there are four parathyroid glands which are embedded in the thyroid tissue. Okay, so there are four parathyroid glands which are present in the posterior aspect of the thyroid gland. So these are the parathyroid glands. Okay, so these parathyroid glands produce the parathyroid hormone. Okay, so they will produce the parathyroid hormone or the PTH, and they will release the PTH hormone into the blood. Okay, so this is the source of the parathyroid hormone, that is the parathyroid glands which are present on the posterior aspect of the thyroid gland. Okay, so now we will take on the functions of parathyroid hormone, like what are the functions of the parathyroid hormone. Okay, so I'm clearing this all. Okay, so let's take on the functions of the parathyroid hormone. Okay, so as the parathyroid hormone is released into the blood, the primary target of the parathyroid hormone is the bone. Okay, so the primary target is the bone. The second target is the kidney. Second target is the kidney. So let's see what happens in the bone. So here we have the bone. I'm drawing the bone. Okay, so as the parathyroid hormone is released, it will go into the bone and it will cause the resorption of calcium and phosphate. Okay, so here is the calcium and here is phosphate. So the PTH hormone, when it acts on the bone, it will cause the resorption of calcium and phosphate. The mechanisms by which the calcium and phosphate are released, that is an entirely different thing. But here we are seeing the big picture. So the big picture is that as the PTH hormone, it acts on the bone, it increases the resorption of calcium and phosphate, and the calcium and phosphate hence are dumped into the blood. So this is the main function that occurs or that happens when the PTH acts on the bone. So now let's see what happens when the PTH acts on the kidney. Okay, so here is the kidney, here is the nephron, the PCT, okay, the loop of Fennel, this is the loop of Fennel, the DCT, and the collecting duct. Okay, so when the PTH acts on the kidney, it has three functions to do. Let's see the first. First, it acts on the PCT. Okay, first it acts on the PCT and it decreases the reabsorption of phosphate. Okay, so it will decrease the reabsorption of phosphate. This is the first function. The next function is on the DCT. Okay, so next it acts on the DCT and it increases the reabsorption of calcium. Okay, so it will increase the reabsorption of calcium. And third, it will again act on PCT. Okay, it will act on PCT and it will increase the expression of an enzyme, a very important enzyme, which is called as 1 alpha hydroxylase. Okay, which is called as 1 alpha hydroxylase enzyme. So again, On the kidney, the PTH has three jobs to do. The first is to act on the PCT and decrease the reabsorption of phosphate from the blood. The second is to act on the DCT and increase the reabsorption of calcium. The third is to act on the PCT again and to increase the expression of 1-alpha hydroxylase enzyme. So clear up till now? So up till now we are clear that the PTH has acted upon the bone and it has acted upon the kidney and it has increased the calcium. Okay, it has increased the calcium in the blood and it has decreased the phosphate in the blood. Now you will ask me why the phosphate is decreased. Here the phosphate is being reabsorbed. Then why the phosphate is decreased? The answer is that, yes, I know phosphate is being resorbed from the bone. But when it goes into the blood and it goes into the urine, the kidney is not able to reabsorb the phosphate. So net result is that phosphate is dumped into the urine. That is why the phosphate is being decreased by the PTH. While since the calcium is reabsorbed from the kidney, therefore the calcium is increased. Okay. So this is the function of the parathyroid hormone on the bone and on the kidney. Now the very important, or I can say another important thing which is related with this concept, is the function of this 1-alpha hydroxylase enzyme, and we cannot leave this 1-alpha hydroxylase enzyme over there. So we have to spend some moment over the 1-alpha hydroxylase enzyme. Okay. So let's see what the 1-alpha hydroxylase enzyme does. Okay. Okay. So we all know that the PTH hormone increases the activity of 1-alpha hydroxylase enzyme. Okay, it increases the activity of 1-alpha hydroxylase enzyme. Now see, this 1-alpha hydroxylase enzyme, what does it do? That it converts the inactive form of vitamin D. I won't go into the details. Inactive vitamin D into active vitamin D. Okay, it will convert the inactive vitamin D into active vitamin D, and now this active vitamin D will have two targets. First target will be intestine. Okay, first target will be intestine and second target will be bone. Okay, second target will be bone. From the intestine, it will increase the absorption. It will increase the absorption of calcium and phosphate. That is all happening because of vitamin D, active vitamin D. And from the bone, it will increase the resorption of calcium and phosphate. So net result due to vitamin D would be that there will be an increase in the calcium and there will be an increase in the phosphate. But we all know the phosphate is increasing as a result of the bone resorption. The ultimate action of the PTH on the kidney will decide whether the phosphate will stay in blood or not. And we know that phosphate will increase the dumping of phosphate into the urine. PTH will increase the dumping of phosphate into the urine. So the net result is that there would be an increase in the calcium due to both PTH and vitamin D, and there will be a decrease in the phosphate level. So these are the functions of the PTH. Okay, so these are the functions of PTH. That is, it increases the calcium in the blood. Okay, so this is the take home point. It increases the calcium in the blood and it decreases the phosphate in the blood. So this is all about the parathyroid hormone. I hope you have understand the concept and I have made this video simple. For more videos like this, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you.